you don't know how we flow on the Michael Colyar Show. Watch real close, tell your folks that it's Michael Colyar turn.
Your television up a little bit, it's about to get ridiculous. He slips through in slick suits with the skits to hit true. How sick is this dude?
I see you.
You don't know.
You don't have no idea
how we flow.
Show. Follow that, we have a fabulous young comedian. Now, what's exciting about tonight's show, a lot of these comedians I ain't never seen before. I don't know what the hell gonna happen. I am as surprised and shocked as y'all are as we go along, you know? But at least that's the excitement of life. We don't know what's coming. You don't know what's coming, man. You don't know what's around the corner, but you keep on going. This young lady, they say, is hilarious. And I didn't know the last brother was from Long Beach, though. The last brother, Jamaria, because I don't mess with people from Long Beach. You know he carrying pistols and shit. For real. He in here joking, but you know right now he outside. Clack, clack, clack. Okay. This young lady is Los Angeles-based. I used to free. Never mind. Los Angeles-based. You don't want to get that joke? The free base? Okay. I'm sorry. She's a comedian and an actress, and she's straight to the point comic spiel. I don't know what that means. But I'm hoping she'll let us know. Get your hands together. Bring out with a lot of love. Wait a minute. Let me tell you, the name of the game is confidence anyway, people. That's the name of performance. The name of the performance game is confidence. If you got enough confidence, you don't even need material. You can just have fun and flow if you got confidence. And how do we give our artists confidence? We bring them out with a great applause, not a so-so applause. Get it together for Mieka J.
Mieka, how y'all doing? I'm Mieka J from LA. I love my city. And you know, it trips me out when people come to LA and they say things about gangs, you know what I mean? And Crips and Bloods and all these kind of things. And I grew up in the hood and I loved it. I had an amazing childhood, and growing up in the hood ain't that bad. The hood is the only place where you can sit your kid on the front porch at 7 in the morning and you ain't got to cook a damn thing all day. Give your kid $3 and sit him on the porch all day. You can sit in the house and watch soaps all day long. They sit on the porch and at 7 a.m. you hear, tamale, tamale, tamale. Breakfast is served. I'm in the house. I still ain't cooked a damn thing. But my kid ate breakfast. I feel like a good parent. I'm just saying, right? Then my kid is outside playing around, you know, and even me as a child. And then you hear ding, 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 ding. That's the donut truck. I used to run. Yeah, we had donut trucks in the hood. I'm telling you, move to the hood. You'll live well. You'll live well. Save some money. You know what I mean? They got to feed them kids. Then you get the donut truck, go out there, spend a little money, you know what I mean? Now you got a donut. Now as a kid, you running around and you playing double dutch with extension cords, you know what I'm saying, and all that kind of stuff. And you hanging out, and then you get to see fun things like smoker shows. That's a crackhead. Crackheads in the hood, it's like the Olympics. Like, you can sit back, and crackheads do strange things. I used to see this one crackhead running fast down the street, about 70 pounds, soaking wet, holding a whole sofa. How are you 70 pounds with a sofa running? That's like Olympics. So I feel like they should make a crackhead Olympics. Would y'all watch that? I would definitely watch that. But I wouldn't get him medals. I'd buy him like a 40. You know what I mean? They love that. You know what I'm saying? So crackhead Olympics. So you outside, you playing, you watching smoker shows. You done had you a snack, which was your donut. And you'd have had the breakfast, which is tamale. Your mama in the house and still ain't cooked a damn thing. And you still got money in your pocket. You know what I'm saying? By now, the sun is going down a little bit, but you still playing. And then you hear, ding, 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 ding. That's the corn man. Y'all know the corn man. That's the Mexican. He pushing a little cart, and then it's like magic. You know, he got the little cooler. Then he opens it up, and it's like steam comes out. You know what I mean? And you sitting there. You're like, can I get a corn with a little mayonnaise and a little chili? You know what I mean? You sit there with your friend still playing. Four. Mama still ain't cooked a damn thing or came outside. $1.50. I'm just saying the hood treats you right. Sun then went down, you know what I mean? And then you hear do 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 do. Ice cream man, baby! Yeah! You run and you get dinner, because your mama still ain't cooked a damn thing. You get chili cheese Fritos. And you put some jalapenos on them chili cheese Fritos and get you a little quarter soda. Woo! Dinner is served. Mama still ain't cooked a damn thing. You know what I mean? Then I was talking to my husband, and I was like, you know, I had a good life. Like, and he was like, baby, no, that's not normal. Like, your mama not cooking? She just put you on a porch in the morning with $3? Like, she should go to jail. And I was like, no, my life was really good. And I was like, so you're telling me you growing up, you never been, like, in your living room, and then you hear, like, pop, 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 and it's gunshots, and then all you do is you hit the lights and you hit the floor. Like, we didn't call the police. You know what I'm saying? We just hit the lights and we hit the floor. And I never understood, why would you turn off the lights? Like, does that mean the bullets can't come in your house now because you turned the lights off? Or all of a sudden, we're not going to shoot her. You know, they're not home. They turned off their lights, so we're going to let them live. I never understood that. And then my grandfather, he would run to the window, and he would peek out. And he'd be like, oh, it's all good. Turn the lights on. Everybody keep partying. Nobody didn't call the police. You know what I mean? Then I'm talking to my husband, and he's like, what? That's not normal. And I'm like, what? A smoker, crackhead, ain't never been just running and hit your back gate and steal your radio and then go running down the street and your whole family chase him down the street and still didn't call the police? That never happened to you? He's like, no, that never happened to me. My husband is a little bougie. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. So if y'all want to stop cooking, y'all go on and move on back to the hood. You know what I'm saying? Your kids will eat well. Look at me. I've been eating very good, you know? I don't have high blood pressure or nothing. Like, I'm good. You know, them chili cheese Fritos did me right in life. You know what I mean? And then you get your vegetables from the corn. You know what I mean? And you're good to go. That's all I am saying. Right. But in L.A., it just trips me out, things that happen. Like, we have some aggressive homeless people. I don't think you guys ever, like, I've been in the car with my kids before, and see, I'm a Christian. Like, my husband's a minister and everything. And, you know, when you're in the car with your children, you want to be a good Christian. But I had this one lady. She comes up to me, and she's like, hi, you know, may I have some change? May I have some change? And I was like, okay. You know, I want it to be nice. Because some of them are aggressive, and you just kind of want to run them over a little bit. You know what I mean? But the kids were in the car, so, you know, you want to be nice. You know what I mean? So I was like, okay, no problem. I got a little change. So I dug, and I handed her a couple of, you know, quarters. When I looked, I noticed that she had her nails done. A full set of nails, and not just a full set of nails, she had a French tip. I don't know if y'all noticed, fellas, but a French tip is $3 extra. My nail's not done, and she telling me she hungry. Tripped me out. All I'm saying is, I'm Mieka J, I'm from LA, and you guys have been amazing.
Give it up, let her hear Mieka J. Oh, Mieka J. Oh, I like her. Mieka J took us back to the hood for real, didn't she? Some of us who've been away from the hood a while, you know, you've been living hood adjacent or somewhere maybe up in, I don't know, maybe you live in West Hollywood or something, you forget what the hood is really like. But she showed us how you could eat good. You could put your kids out front. See, because you know them black kids. Them black kids, because nobody steal black kids. You know, there might be an Amber alert, but you ain't never heard, like, of a Tasha alert. If everybody take Tasha, they bringing Tasha back, okay? You ain't going to hear none of that. I took notes watching her because she was fabulous.
This next artist really illustrates it. I just want you to, Gerald Rivers, come out, please. His name is Mr. Gerald Rivers. What I want to say about him is he does so much, okay? First of all, he teaches African drums. He teaches how to play African drums. The brother directs and teaches Shakespeare, which I think is awesome. We need more black people doing Shakespeare, you know, because it is not very far from rap, Shakespeare and rap. When you try to really compare them, you will see how close they are to blow your mind. But one thing that he does, and say hello to them, tell them where you're from.
I'm originally from Compton, California.
Yeah, from Compton. And what he's going to do for us this evening is he does the voice of Martin Luther King, but he doesn't just do the speech. I believe that he channels him. And so I give you Gerald. What's your last name again?
Rivers.
Rivers, ladies and gentlemen. Give him a round of applause.
Just want to say thank you, Mike, for all you do, good brother. God bless you, homie. New opportunities have opened within the last few years, and this will be even greater. All over the United States and all over the world, doors have been opened that have been closed to the Negro and other minorities in the past. The great challenge that we face is to be ready to enter these doors when they open. Ralph Waldo Emerson. Ralph Waldo Emerson said in a lecture back in 1871 that if a man can write a better book or preach a better sermon or make a better mousetrap than his neighbor, even if he builds his house in the woods, the world will make a beaten path to his door. This will become increasingly true. That means we're going to have to work hard. We are going to have to burn the midnight oil sometimes. We are going to have to take advantage of new opportunities, and we must set out to do our life's work so well that nobody could do it better. We must seek to do a good job. But we must not seek merely to do a good Negro job. If you're setting out to be merely a good Negro doctor, a good Negro lawyer, a good Negro teacher, a good Negro preacher, a good Negro skilled laborer, a good Negro barber, a good Negro beautician, you've already flunked your matriculation exam for entrance into the University of Integration. We must get ready. We must set out to do a good job and to do that job so well that the living, the dead, or the unborn couldn't do it better. As I've said so often, if it falls your lot to be a street sweeper, go on out and sweep streets like Michelangelo carved marble. Sweep streets like Raphael painted pictures. Sweep streets like Beethoven composed music and like Shakespeare wrote poetry. Sweep streets so well that all the host of heaven and earth will have to pause and say, here lived a great street sweeper who swept his job well. This is it. You can be a pine on the top of the hill, then be a shrub in the valley, but be the best little shrub on the side of the rill. Be a bush if you can't be a tree. If you can't be a highway, just be a trail. If you can't be the sun, be a star. For it isn't by size that you win or you fail. You just be the best of whatever you are. And if any of you are around here when I have to meet my day, I don't want a long funeral. And if you get somebody to deliver the eulogy, tell them not to talk too long. Tell them not to mention that I have a Nobel Peace Prize. That isn't important. Tell them not to mention that I have 300 or 400 other awards. That's not important. Tell them not to mention where I went to school. On that day, I want somebody to be able to say that Martin Luther King Jr. tried to love somebody. I want them to say that I tried to be right on the wall question. I want them to say that I did try in my life to clothe those who were naked. I want them to say that I did try in my life to feed the hungry. I want them to say that I did try in my life to visit the sick and imprisoned. I want them to say that I tried to love and serve humanity. Yes, if you want to say that I was a drum major, say that I was a drum major for peace. Say that I was a drum major for righteousness, and all of the other shallow things will not matter. I won't have any money to leave behind. I won't have the fine and luxurious things of life to leave behind, but I just want to leave a committed life. That's all I want to say. If I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with a word or song, if I can show somebody he's traveling wrong, then my living will not be in vain. Yes, Jesus, I want to be on your right or your left side. Not for any selfish reasons. I want to be on your right or your left side, not in terms of some political ambition or kingdom. I just want to be there in love and in justice and in truth and in commitment to others so that we can make of this old world a new world.
God bless. That's Gerald River. Come on now, Mr. Gerald River.
You don't know how we flow on the Michael Colyar Show. Watch real close. Tell your folks that it's Michael Colyar turn.
Your television up a little bit. It's about to get ridiculous. He slips through in slick suits with the skits to hit true. How sick is this dude?
I see you.
You don't know.
You don't know.